Hello students, welcome to your computer class. Today we will learn how to add a tab stop to your document. As we have studied earlier that the tab stop helps to control the placement of the text in a page. Now first you will understand what do I mean by this. Okay, see, now here is a paragraph. You see, it is highlighted. Are you able to see here? Speed. Okay. Yes, the topic is speed, that is highlighted. Now, suppose I want to change its position like this. You see, this is a bit shifted towards the right side. Are you able to see this one? From the main paragraph, it is shifted little bit towards the right side. Here you see earlier it was just as it is in main document and now it is like this. So what are the steps if you want to make alignment like this of your text? So today we'll study that. Okay. So now before that, I'll explain you what is the function of the normal tab key. The normal tab key, what it does, it moves half inch towards the right normally. Okay, from the insertion point where your cursor is blinking, it will move towards half inch towards the right. Now then if we are not very particular about half inch, we want to move less or more, then what to do? Here comes the role of the tab stop key. Now what does this key helps us? The tab stop key allows the user to change the movement according to his will. Now by default it can move only half inch, but if I want to move less than or more than that, then it is used according to that. Okay. So now, what are some commonly used tab stop keys? So just pay attention to the labels given here. These labels will be, you will find on your computer screen. See, this one, these labels will identify which type of tab stop key you are using. Now left tab. Now this key helps to left align the text at the tab. So this tab will have to left align. What's the meaning of left align? Left align means to make your text just equal towards the left side. Okay, it will make, see here, no, this means some character is not here, some character is not here. It is all aligned properly, na, in one line. So the role of left tab is it helps to left align the text at the tab. Now what is the role of center tab? The role of the center tab, it helps to center the text around the tab. So the text will be centered around the tab. Okay, means main center will be where the tab position will be and all the document will be aligned according to that. Now come to right tab. It helps to right align the text at the tab stop. Now where you will put the tab stop, the right tab stop, all your text will be right aligned, means towards the right side all the text will be aligned properly in one line. It will not be here and there. So these are the roles of left tab, center tab and right tab. Now we will learn here how to align this, how to use these tabs to align our text. Okay, now to add a tab stop, what we have to do first? First, we have to select a paragraph that we want to align. Okay. So here you see this paragraph has been selected. So this paragraph will be aligned. We have selected this paragraph. Now, next step is what? Click the tab selector or until the tab stop you want to use appears. Now we will see here is the left tab selector key and we will click here. Okay. Now, what will be the next step? Now what you have to do, click on the desired location at the horizontal ruler where we want your text to appear. Now you'll move this one. Okay, this ruler will appear and will move this part where we want to see. Here it was aligned here, this part, you pay attention, this was aligned here, so whole text was aligned like this. Okay, now I have moved this one, this alignment little bit this side. Okay, it will be moved here, you see, this is moved here. Okay, and so the selected text has been moved to this place. Okay, so that text jumps here, it comes here, and hence we add the tab stop and our text is aligned as we want it to be. Okay, now removing tab stops. If you want to remove the tab stop, click and drag it off from the ruler. So this is the horizontal ruler and this is the vertical ruler. If you see minutely in your computer, you will see like a scale that you use. Have you use your scale in mathematics, na, to draw lines? Similar scale is there in the computer also for marking. It is also marked as your scale is marked there. Okay, it is also marked there and it is also used to properly place the text. Now, so if we want to remove the tab stop, what we do? Just click and drag it off from the ruler. Just click here and drag it off, remove it. Actually, it means that drag it off means take it outside or remove it from the ruler and the tag stop will be removed. Okay, so this was the process of applying a tab stop and removing the tab stop. Now, next one you have to see is indentation. Now, what first we'll understand what is the meaning of an indent and then we'll know how to apply it. Now, children, when you open your book also, have you seen there is some space left from the right side, left side, top margin, bottom margin? Have you noticed it? Yes, that is nothing but the indent. Okay, so now here, indent is the space or gap of the text from the edge of the margin, from the edge or the margin. Okay, now the margin setting are applied to the whole document. Now the margins, what you have to apply will be apply to the whole document or the text area, but indentation setting sets the space paragraph from the margin with respect to the text that is below or above it using the indent commands. Okay, so now margin setting sets the space for whole document. But when we do indentation, what do we do? We do spacing for a particular paragraph. Now, what are the steps? what are the steps we are required to do while we do indentation. Okay, so first of all, for any formatting, what we do, we have to select a particular paragraph. Okay, now once we select the particular paragraph, then what we do, click on the desired indent command from the paragraph command. So here you see, from here, see, this is paragraph menu, and see, this is paragraph menu, and we will select the desired indentation. Okay, we'll select the desired indentation, and then what we have to increase the indent. So what we'll do, you see, it is increased here. So this increases the indent by half is to the right. In our example, we increase the indent. See, here it is increased. Here, see, here it was aligned properly. Now it has been increased. Half is indentation has been done here. Similarly, if we want to decrease, similar process has been applied. Just click on the paragraph option. Click on the paragraph option and then click on indentation, and then you can decrease it. Okay, you can decrease according to your choice. So in today's chapter, what did we learn? We learned to apply the tab stops and apply the indentation in your document. Okay, that's all for today's video. Thank you, children.